Hey, Splendid here. I just wanted to take some time today to talk about the division of roles and the anti-everything problem in Company of Heroes. So, there's essentially two types of damage in CO that matter: infantry damage and vehicle damage. The type of damage a unit deals defines its role. Let's look at Penals from CO 2, for example. They spawn with SVTs and deal really good infantry damage, and they can go toe to toe and then some with their German counterparts in their default role. However, the player can choose to upgrade the Penals with a PTRS package. This removes two of the SVTs with anti-tank rifles, reducing the unit's effectiveness against infantry, but allowing the Penals to deal damage against vehicles.
They also get a sticky satchel
that further enforces the idea that the role has changed from anti-infantry to anti-tank. We can see here pre-upgrade, they go toe-to-toe with the Grenadiers and actually wipe the floor with them. But once both units have their respective upgrades, the dynamic is completely changed and the Penals get stomped by the Grenadiers. And we can see this type of choice the player has to make throughout all different types of units in Company Heroes. Take the US Paratroopers, for example. They have the choice between machine guns, bazookas, and Thompsons, depending on how the player wants them to fit into their army composition and what role the player wants them to fulfill. This is one of the many choices the player has to make to create a balanced composition of multiple roles to be able to adapt to all situations in the game. However, Relic like to dabble in the idea of anti-everything. The unit that says, you know what, I'ma do both, just watch me. For those old enough to remember, when Volk had Shreks, sort of similar to the Jaeger Shrek blobs of CO 3, or the Boys AT rifle blobs, the division of role is blurred and the unit excels in both. The game removes the decision for the player. It becomes too easy to just build said unit because they can do everything, fight everything. One of the most controversial and most popular anti-everything units might be the Guards from CO 2. They spawn with two anti-tank rifles and four Mosins, but can be upgraded with two DP light machine guns, giving them four weapon slots. But unlike their penal comrades, their PTRS rifles do more damage to infantry than the standard. Along with the firing precision ability and their button vehicle ability, they are a truly incredible unit that can help you in a variety of situations. I was actually hoping CO 3 would move away from units like this, but they seem to be embracing it more and trying to make a variety of these sort of anti-everything units.
When it comes to damage, infantry essentially have two roles: anti-infantry or anti-tank, and the weapons we equip them with will help them fulfill this role.
Anti-infantry, anti-tank. Anti-infantry, anti-tank. Let's look at CO 2 Panzer Grenadiers, for example. They spawn with four STGs and they excel in anti-infantry combat. However, the player, if they choose to, can upgrade them with two Panzerschrecks, removing two of the STGs and halving their anti-infantry capability because the player has chosen to make them an anti-tank unit, essentially. So, in a 1v1 against Riflemen, a fight they once dominated now is a struggle for them because they only have two SVTs to fight back with. And as soon as they lose a model, they only have one SVT to fight back with. And that's the way it should be. Even though the riflemen are cheaper and have no upgrades, they should still win because their role is anti-infantry and that of the Panzer Grenadiers is not. And that makes sense. That makes the flow of play more engaging. And that's where these anti-everything units in CO 3 are a little bit odd. You know, let's look at Jaegers, for example, in CO 3. So for 320 manpower, you get 5 men, trained in camo, and they have 5 G43 rifles. However, at the cost of 90 munitions, you can upgrade and replace one of these G43s with a Panzerschreck. And that's a big deal, only replacing one G43. They still have 4 G43s left to fire infantry. And that Panzerschreck deals so much damage by itself, it doesn't need an additional one. You know, it's the whole package. The Jaegers will come out on top versus plain riflemen when they're both the anti-infantry role, which makes sense because they cost more. You know, they're a more elite unit. But even with the Panzerschreck upgrade and a little bit of accuracy, they still come out on top against riflemen who only have anti-infantry weapons. See, the role isn't defined. They're still good at both. And that to me is an issue. I think if the role definition was clearer, the counterplay is more obvious, right? There just needs to be a downside for putting Shrek on the Jaeger. Like, it was so clear before, you know, in previous games. It was like, in previous games, they lost like half their anti-infantry capability, but they could fight vehicles, and that's fine. But now it's like, oh, I can kind of still do both. I still have like a lot of men with G43 rifles that are good to go. And it's just like, oh, it's a little bit weird. But right now, Relic are sort of not just dipping their toe into the realm of these all-rounder units, these anti-everything units, but they're sort of plunging in. And I think it's not good for like conventional counterplay. You know, I want to know in my heart that that my dedicated anti-infantry unit is going to outright win against this like all-rounder that's got like Panzerschrecks or bazookas on them as well as bars or whatever. It's just a little bit too easy to sort of blob these all-round anti-units. It's really boring to play against, and it's super boring to watch. The way I would fix this issue, and disclaimer, I'm not a game designer, I'm just a co-fan, is like by reducing the damage of the Shrek by half and adding an additional Panzerschreck replacing another rifle. So it's reducing its overall anti-infantry capability, making it a more dedicated anti-tank unit and less of like an all-rounder. Or maybe the Jaegers could spawn with Kar 98s instead of G43s, and the G43s could be locked behind some kind of package, you know? That way they wouldn't have both the G43s and the Shrek at the same time. I don't know, there's probably multiple ways to get around it. And just to be clear, this isn't about Jaegers, you know, this is an issue in Code 3 that affects like a lot of units, you know? You got your Foot Guards, Rangers, Boys, Anti-Tank, it's an issue throughout the game. I'm just using Jaegers here as an example. You know, the Scots Guards, for example, I think they're a bit weird to use because they have such a strange weapon composition of two bazookas and four Thompsons. They should spawn with like six Lee Enfields at a lower MP cost with two upgrades available to them with the appropriate muni cost. One being a Thompson package similar to the one the Gurkhas get, and the other being bazookas. Because right now having this anti-tank, close-range anti-infantry section is just weird, right? You know, you don't want to really run them in because they're expensive, but you kind of have to. And you know, two of their models are carrying bazookas, so they're not like outright winning. You're still bleeding a lot of manpower. It's just weird. Like, I don't know what they want me to do with them. Like, when you're fighting trash like Grands or Coastals, that's fine. But as soon as you're fighting a unit that's not garbage, you know, it's like, it's sore, you know, it's heavy on the manpower bleed. But spawning in with six Lee Enfields and two options of upgrades gives the player a choice on how they can play with the guards, keeping them anti-infantry, medium to long range, or keep making them close range experts or anti-tank hunters. You know, it would really help like players' flexibility and help them remove this anti-everything feeling to the unit. I suppose Rangers are the new anti-everything unit with their six weapon slots and those RNG loot box crates things that drop down. I mean, they can basically kill anything, anytime. I was doing some experiments in the Code 3 cheat mod thing, seeing exactly what they could kill, and they can just kill everything. Anyway, I won't get too bogged down in it. In summary, stronger role definition equals clearer counterplay and increased skill expression. This way we don't need to be overly worried about your anti-infantry squad losing against an anti-everything squad. I also think this would help reduce the effectiveness of blobbing in the game. Also, quick side note, it shouldn't just apply to infantry, I think it could be applied to certain vehicles too. Like, I feel like the Shtug should be able to do zero damage to infantry, like barely tickle them. I think the Shtug should be a budget tank destroyer. That's its whole job, you know? If it's doing more than that, it's overperforming. Anyways, that's just my thoughts on the matter. Maybe you disagree, that's fine. Maybe you like the all-purpose feeling of sort of general anti-everything units, and that's fine. You can enjoy it while it's there. But I just think it's bad for the game. Anyway, I've been Splendid. It's always a pleasure, never a chore. Peace.